This is Erica with Launching Legacies. Welcome to our daily devotional. Today we are finishing our devotional series on cleaning the soil. And you'll notice that I'm not with my usual backdrop, which is the books behind me. Instead, I have this plant behind me. And this is the plant that we've been working, that I was working on to restore. And you'll notice that it's quite large. It's quite large. And so that's why we had to come to it, really bringing it to us wasn't a good idea. So here goes the summary of our devotional series that we really need to understand. That, listen, your soil is a reflection of you. And so if your soil's not well, then the truth is you're probably not well. But we've talked about cleaning up contaminated soil. And I want to remind everyone that it's something that we need to continuously monitor and something that we need to be aware of in every, throughout our life, throughout our journey. It's not something that we start this beginning of our life with and or our life with Christ with, and then we don't have to look at again. No, we need to keep checking our soil. We need to keep checking what's going on in our life and making sure that we're well, because when we're not well, the world knows typically before we know, unless we're checking for it, right? Unless we're mindful of the things that look like contamination in our life. And they start with thoughts, right? And they go into feelings and actions and deeds. And then sooner or later, we can see, because the world can see, that that we're not doing too good, you know? And sometimes, you know, if you notice my plant, there's a leaf over here that has a little bit of bruising, or it got torn in the process of being transplanted. And it just kind of fell over incorrectly and got torn. And so sometimes we're wounded, but that leaf, even though it's torn a bit, is still healthy. And this plant is very strong and it's growing and it's super tall. You can tell it's super tall, but it's growing and it's strong. And we have to be like that too, right? We have to be strong despite whatever adversity we may have to go through. So this plant has been transplanted, replanted, it's been put into water, suspended with nutrients, and it's gone through a lot of things. And maybe you have too, but the whole point is, in order to be a demonstration of goodness, you got to continue to monitor yourself towards that goodness. And so I want to end with just this passage from Ephesians 4. It's the rest of the passage, right? From the potato test, we said the things we need to get rid of, right? From Ephesians 4:31 was get rid of all the bitterness and the anger and the rage, the harsh words and the slander, as well as all types of evil behavior. But then it says instead, for verse 32, it says instead be kind to each other. Tender-hearted, forgiving one another, just as God through Christ has forgiven you. And so the big idea here is that even if you, when you make yourself well, we need to focus on actually doing good things and bearing good fruit. And our soil is the first thing that will tell us, right? It'll tell us if we're well. And remember, it starts in the mind and the heart. Our feelings and our emotions start to be in places that we don't want to be. We don't want to be bitter or anger or frustrated or whatnot. So we have to do the work. It's plain and simple, we have to do the work. And once we do the work, then we'll be able to determine whether or not we are in fact well. So God bless you. We're praying for you. We hope that you've enjoyed this devotional series, and look at the beautiful plant and how strong it is. It's turned towards the light, so it looks a little bit weird from this angle, I think. But nonetheless, it's strong, and I pray the same for you, that you would be strong and that you would grow and that you would be well and that you would work through whatever contaminants might be in your soil so that you can bear good fruit. All right. Thank you for being with us. Again, we'll see you again Monday morning with another of our devotional series. And until then, be blessed.